It's about the fun of traveling around and just new adventures, and everything's different. It's never the same. You always learn something every day when you do this job. I mean, a designer that you never heard of, a little nuance about a piece of furniture that maybe you were aware of, but just kind of, you know, put the last chapter in your book of that piece. And it just, you know, that's what makes it interesting. It's always constant. I'm Mark Fisk, and I am one of the owners of Mainly Art Vintage Modern Furniture here in Cincinnati, Ohio. I'm partners with my wife, Missy, and we've been in business for 21 years. Started off in a small little space. We were at about 500 square feet, and today our store is 10,000 square feet of all vintage modern furniture. I was in the corporate world. Was looking for a chair. And I just happened to go into an antique shop, and there was an Eames bucket chair. You know, just a simple little fiberglass chair. I saw it and I was like, wow, what is this? I got really excited, and I'd never seen one before. So I asked the guy, well, how much you want for it? And he's like, 30 bucks. So I bring it home, I get it to the wife, and she's like, wow, where'd you find that? I'm like, oh, this little junk store. And then we started to do some research. And of course, this was before the internet was very popular, so you had to go buy a book. And we went through all these books and found the designer, the name, and we just got so interested that it just became a passion. We do a lot of rentals. We do a lot of the movie projects in Cincinnati, especially the ones that deal with the 40s to the 70s, and that's what we specialize in. We do a lot of commercial shoots, too, for telephone companies and, you know, different corporations, and that's a nice thing to have because you get to see your furniture on television or in a movie. It's exciting. And we're doing this Miles Davis movie with Don Cheadle's in this one, and we just got finished with a movie that has Cate Blanchett in it. The Mad Men show has done really wonders for our business in the mid-century modern world. It's just put it out to the, you know, to the public. They're getting to see the furniture now, and they're understanding the simple design, quality, and the good craftsmanship, and seeing it in context like that makes it interesting. As a matter of fact, we sold some stuff to John Slattery, and we did his New York townhouse, and met him and his wife Talia, and it was very interesting. Super nice guy. He's interested in modern and has a passion for it. The effect on our business has been tremendous with the internet. It's just been one of those things where it's a worldwide web. 70% of our business is out of Cincinnati, Ohio. So you're doing New York, Chicago, Miami, and people from all over the world are contacting you, buying and selling. And we do a lot of foreign business here. A large part of our business, surprisingly, is Japan, because the Japanese have a very, you know, simple aesthetic. So that works well with what we're selling, and they like quality. We definitely deal with everything from around the world. We're selling things made in Italy. We do a lot of Danish modern. Of course, American is very important, especially to a foreign audience, because it's made in America and they see that. So they're, you know, more interested. If you're in Italy, you're not going to buy Italian furniture. You're going to buy, you know, something that's from another country. And same with us. We do the same thing. My best experiences are just traveling around and finding it. I mean, and meeting people. I mean, it's the best job in the world. You get to go anywhere you want. You get to go poking around in people's homes, and you get to meet them, and they tell you the story about it. That's our best part. We love to hear the story about the piece of furniture. We bought an Eames rocker, and the lady started crying when I was taking it out of the house. And I said, well, why are you crying? And she said, I raised 5 kids, and I rocked all of them in this chair, and none of my kids wanted it. And I'm like, you're kidding me. She said, no, they didn't want to take it. I said, call your kids on the phone and make sure they don't want it, because when I take it, they're not going to see it again. Someone else is going to love and covet it. That's kind of a, you know, the things we like to see. People are passionate about the chair, the piece of furniture, the history of it, the design of it, and that's what we really, you know, lock into with people. The next turn is always the next 10 years. You know, right now we're getting a lot of calls for 70s. You know, it's going to the Studio 54 look. You know, satin brass is back. So now you're looking into the 80s. And I always tell my wife, I said, when they call and they want stuff from 2010, I'm retiring. I mean, that's going to be the end for me. You know, but it just keeps every 30 years. My mother always said it, and she said it the best. She goes, keep it 30 years, it'll be worth something. And that's kind of the trend we're on. So there's always the next horizon, the next new designer, the next new object. So I see no end to it till I'm done.